Hello, my friends. This is Wolfgang with Tools for Ascension. And today I'm going to show you how to connect your head and your heart. Okay? Very important and very important for good quality of life. So in my personal history, my mom was always nagging, especially at dinner time or at any time we were eating, because I couldn't get away. And I actually retreated from my heart into my head, so to be able to handle this emotionally. So, I became emotionally cold and very cynical, a head case, so to say. Very analytic, and in Germany, this is kind of a virtue. And so I basically, and then with mantra meditation, focusing from anything from 2 to 4 hours a day onto a mantra, my third eye was like a steel trap, or like a train light at the locomotive up front. So I had to really learn to withdraw from this point of view and start to get centered in my heart. And let me just explain why this is important. So when we are connected with our lower energy centers, with the earth energy only, and that extreme, we are in harmony with the Earth Mother. Let's say when you have a strong root chakra, you have a strong body, a strong spine in general, a good metabolism, very good body coordination, fight and flight. And you have a full root chakra, you're very dangerous to fight with, for instance. And because you're very well connected to your animal body. And So when you have a strong earth connection and no heaven connection, you become a good materialist. You might have several nice cars, or secretaries and good business, and you have lots of money. But if there is no connection in the higher chakra, you do not necessarily have an appreciation for the finer things of life. Gratitude, and other, spiritual things. Now, in contrast to that, if you are only open on the higher chakras and, you're not grounded, means you're not running much earth energy, first of all, you do not drain out your negative emotions that sewer out through gravity, into the earth when you are grounded, or if you are grounded. You get then all those downloads, from the heavens, where the ideas come from that trickle into you, and you have all those great ideas. Oh, let us open a healing center and take care of homeless people, etc. Great ideas on helping. And of course, they have a problem, even paying their rent or hold down a job. so-called space cadets. Right, so to be able to function properly in the earth plane, you have to be grounded, and then from that you can extend into the heavens and get the inspiration, and then you can manifest it through your physical vehicles. So both is needed, and if you want to be functional, the more you want to get into the heavens, into the abstract plane, the more you have to be grounded. Because if you have too much abstract plane, you lose touch with reality. And you might be institutionalized if you don't get it together, or are dependent on others. Mm-hmm. So we do not want to be a space cadet. So this is why being centered in the heart chakra, is so important. When you are here, you become a space cadet, or maybe a logical psychopath. because many fanaticism basically comes from concepts, a male thing. If you connect it with your heart, you're not a fanatic anymore. You have compassion and mercy. Only fanatics that are in the head, that do things for the principle and just throw compassion out of the way. The throat and the head are basically thought sender, a modem to send thoughts and ideas, or also to receive thoughts and ideas. So we want to have this a most loving, they have the most loving energy, you know, for this. So in my opinion, you know, I really enjoy my heart chakra, but I want this whole area feeling as good as my heart chakra, and also be infused with love. Make sure they are friends, right? So I want to make my heart make friends with my brain, so they work together. Okay, this is the idea. So we close our eyes and we ask, you know, absolute source, the highest being, the creator of everything, to please guide and protect us while we open ourselves up, protect us from the service to self people, and guide us to the highest good, you know, in divine harmony with the most benevolent outcomes align with this. Just say amen or yes or who or right. Okay. And now just connect to the Earth Mother initially. Smile and take a deep inhale and draw her love into your heart, and then send your love down to her. So we hook up to the most easily available source of energy. Exhale all the way. Don't be shy, suck it up, and one more time all the way out. This is just to purify the pathways into the earth, and then yeah, this is starting to feel really good. And now let's send this love into the brain. And then just do as if the brain is loving and pull the love from the brain into your heart. Now on the inhale. And then on the exhale, you push your heart love into the brain. And then really smile like an idiot. I mean, unless you're in a conference room or, you know, sit in a park bench in public, you know, if you're in the park bench, you might be frisked for drugs. And just tell your brain, I love you, and then tell your heart, I love you. And smile, 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 like if, as if you are in love. Completely in love with your brain and with your heart. They're becoming best buddies now. And actually we asked our higher self and our spirit guides to please remove any blockages and resistances that are there in our energy system, maybe from past life trauma, or maybe from black magic curses, etc., or ghosts that we picked up, or technologies, you know, from aliens, or like voodoo doll technology. Whatever it is, we like to have cleared right now as much as possible. Amen. So just agree. And keep, you know, running that love back and forth between head and heart. Oh yeah, I can definitely feel an uplifting for myself. And we also asked the spirit guides to remove any parasites and cords and anything else that has to be removed but that we haven't mentioned yet. Our high self knows. And we asked the highest spiritual authority to please clear this and now. Amen, 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 amen. Well, for me, it's just going automatically right now. I used to do this with mantra meditation. Now it's the, oh my God, this is wonderful. And just smile and watch it. And we ask the spirit guides to facilitate a wonderful information exchange between the heart and the head intelligences, so that they, as friends, cooperate with each other and have a synergistic relationship. This means that their strengths together are more than the sum of the individual strengths. Amen, amen, amen. And we ask that this be blessed and it cannot be interrupted or disturbed by or hacked by service to self entities. Amen, amen, amen. We ask Source, Archangel Michael, or other protectors, like Mountain Singer Dave, or whatever tradition you're coming from. Amen. And as we are very radiant now, let us just, if you're staying at home, let's just pull all the energy onto your skin with your breath, like, and then on the exhale, compact it into your spine. It becomes a lightsaber. So one more time to the skin. Lightsaber to the skin, lightsaber, and then we ask that we be protected by a force field, by a tube of light that only lets positive energies in and drives negative energies out away from it. Now, amen, amen, amen. We thank our spirit guides. We ask for their continued support, guide, and protection wherever it is for the highest best. We invite their guidance from now on. Amen. And 1, 2, 3. You can open your eyes now. You're completely grounded, full of energy, and harmonized. I hope, don't drive, don't operate heavy machinery. And what's the other videos? If this helped you, I do personal session, give me a thumbs up, communicate through the comments. There are many people like you, there's a tribe, this is time to wake up and see how others are doing. I'm here to help out as much as I can. Again, I do private session if you need any help. I love you. Namaste.